there, first grade. This is Mrs. King with another one of your writing lessons. Should be very familiar with this anchor chart by now. Opinion writing tells others what you think, tries to convince others to agree with you by giving reasons and details to support your opinion. Each paragraph has a topic sentence, detailed sentences, and a conclusion. Now, last time we worked on our writing, you completed this graphic organizer that includes a topic sentence right here. Now, I reminded you that your topic sentence, if you were struggling with that, you could go back and think about what you wrote for a topic sentence for the best fruit and for the best outdoor activity. Next, we move down to the reasons why. On this graphic organizer, there are three. I challenged you to come up with five. We talked specifically how the reasons that you give for your toy being your favorite toy should include specific details. I don't want to see words like, it's great, it's fun, I love it. I want the specific reasons or details that makes that toy fun, your favorite. So make sure when you're writing your paragraph that you're double checking that your 3 to 5 reasons why are detailed, specific reasons why that toy is your favorite. Then we're going to move down to the bottom here where there is a concluding sentence. So for this work, I'm going to ask that you just write it on a piece of notebook paper. Now, when we are writing paragraphs, you want to remember all of the details that your first grade teachers have been working with you all year long. You want to think about sentences start with uppercase letters. They end with end marks. You want to be paying attention to your handwriting. Are you forming the letters how your teacher taught you? Do you have spaces in between each word? Are the sight words that we've worked on this year in your writing, are they spelled correctly? Another thing you want to think about, do all of the sentences that you write, do they make sense? A great way to think about that is once you've written your paragraph down, is to whisper read it out loud. That is a great way to check to see if your sentences make sense. Now, I'm going to ask you to keep this paragraph that you write wherever you write it down. If you write it in a notebook or a piece of paper, hang on to it. You don't need to turn it into your teacher yet. Like the last time, your final activity will be submitting your final work through Seesaw. So for this work, I just want you to take this graphic organizer, again, that has a topic sentence, 3 to 5 reasons, detailed reasons why the toy that you chose is your favorite, and a concluding sentence. So this time, we all can't wait to see what your favorite toy is and the reasons why. Remember, I did talk to the first grade team, and we do not want to hear about a video game. Even if it is your favorite, we want you to choose a different toy. All right, we can't wait to see what you come up with, first grade.